I'm Kim Kesty, and I'm super excited to be here to do the make and take tutorial for your Happy Place Project Kit. Now, hopefully this project makes you as happy as it made me as we go through crafting four different projects, all fully kitted in your Happy Place Project Kit. So go ahead and grab that out, empty your box, get ready to go, and we will walk through all four of the cards. The first card we're going to do, I'm going to set this up a little bit differently than I have in the past. I don't often show the finished project first, but I thought, you know what, let's go ahead and give the little preview of what we're going to be making. So the very first card we're going to start with is this Wish You Were Here card, which I absolutely adore. She looks so peaceful there and wishing she had a little friend. And of course, the project kit that matches it is your card kit here, is exactly all the pieces that you can see on the finished project. So there's your little sneak peek of the project, and then I'm going to walk you through step by step how to create it. So you'll need two items also from your kit, the pool with a view die set. That's this guy. So you've got your pool, your little leaves, even your little pool ladder, which I love. And of course, all your other little accessories. And the Make a Splash stamp set. Oh my gosh, you guys are going to have such a blast with this. I feel a little bit sad that we're only using one stamp from this whole entire stamp set on this card. But each individual piece makes such a statement that you totally can do that. You could pick one stamp out and make it just shine. Or you can combine a whole bunch of stamps together. And of course, as this new product becomes available, we are going to be sharing so much fun inspiration. Made tons of cards with the stamp set, and I know you will just love it too. So those two guys you will need. Now, one little caveat as I start digging into my kit here, my stamp set that I'm going to be working with does not have the indexing on it. So I am going to go ahead and grab my cute little floating lady here. But of course, the stamps on your kit will be indexed, but you will see that, oh, this is kind of sad because it doesn't have the indexed photo on the back. Now this piece of whipped cream cardstock, you've actually got two. I'm going to kind of separate my kit out here before I make a mess. You've got two panels of whipped cream. Now one you want to use for your mat that's going to go with this green guy. So don't stamp or cut on this bigger piece, okay? So that's your little heads up. Take the smaller piece of whipped cream. We're going to use this both for the stamping and the die cutting. So I'm going to want to stamp her just on part of this. And then I'm going to save a little bit left for my umbrella. So don't stamp right in the middle, which I know you guys normally wouldn't do anyway. I'm just stamping this little bathing beauty in black licorice. Okay, so I'm going to grab my Color Burst pencils and I'm just going to color away. So just go ahead and color your little gal, and you can use, of course, any color palette if you want. If you've got certain special colors that, you know, speak to you, go ahead and use those. And you'll notice as I went coloring along, I would often take two shades of a similar color, like these two teals. So I would do the lighter shade first, and then I would come back in and do a little bit of highlight with a darker shade. So that's basically my technique. There's really nothing too tricky about it. So again, kind of fuss with it, play with it, get it till you are happy. She's looking pretty peaceful. I went ahead and left her eyeglasses kind of white. I know it's probably a little bit hard to tell in the video, but I left her glasses so they look like they have a little bit of a white frame. Yeah, so sweet. So now I will just take my little detail shears and just detail cut around here. She doesn't need a whole lot. It's pretty easy. Just so she can pop up when we do our pool. All right, so we've got our little bathing beauty here. So now we're going to start with our die cutting. So you want to go ahead and grab your pool with a view, and pretty much the rest of this is going to be just a lot of die cutting assembly. So set her aside. So we're going to be cutting the edge of the pool. So we're going to want to cut it both with the frame and the inside out of our oatmeal cookie. This is going to be the edging of our pool. And then you've got this really cool piece that's already embossed for you. And you will see that you have kind of a debossed side and an embossed side. No right or wrong way. Either way is just fine. So I actually think I'll do my inside of my pool first. So you'll just need the inside part. So you can look at the photo of the postcard you got in your kit. And then I can kind of see that my pool's positioned about this way. You know, if you want your waves somewhat straight. And then, like I said, with that pool edging, you're going to need both pieces. You can kind of position them. If you think you need a little dab of washi tape, that's fine. But you may be able to just line them up just fine. I kind of get them on my platform first and then do one last check. Now you can take the extra step and do the embossing on this one. That would be really cool. This does have just a really faint edging around the edge of the pool. So if you did emboss that with your embossing sandwich, that would even pop more. We're gonna cut both pieces of our umbrella. First, I'm just gonna cut just the outline without the inside piece. And then I'm gonna use both pieces together for the top of my umbrella. And last, we'll do our ladder and our leaves. So I'm gonna line up all the pieces here. We've got our pool, we've got three of each leaf, your umbrella and the umbrella top, your little pool ladder. In your kit, you do have three little spring blooms, which we die cut for you. Your card base is the Limeade Splash, so we can go ahead and fold that in half. Get that guy ready to go. Then you've got your white mat and your fun little piece of lemongrass. And if your paper's a little bit too long or a little bit too big for this mat, go ahead and trim it down just a little bit. You may even have to shave just a little bit more off the side. I think that's what I'm gonna do. Just, who knows, maybe an eighth an inch or so. You just wanna even up your mat. Now we're gonna go ahead and work on completing this whole panel, and then we'll end up putting it on our card base. So I thought it would be fun just to work with these guys first of all. I'm gonna put my pool down with adhesive, but then I'm gonna switch to regular glue or craft glue for my little border. Okay, now one little piece that you had in your kit, which I should have pointed out, you've got one little yellow brad in your kit. So that was in a little Ziploc. And so I thought it'd be fun to just put a little accent in the middle of this guy. So now we've got that great beach umbrella look. Now we're gonna bring our little lady in here. It's just all about, you know, positioning it, layering things, gluing them. Some you want popped up. Actually, I'm gonna stamp the sentiment real quick. So for my stamp, I'm gonna grab the Wish You Were Here sentiment. And your strip is probably a little bit wider also than you need. That's just so we can make sure we get it as straight as possible. And again, now you wanna bring your trimmer in and just trim it a little bit narrower. And honestly, you could do as wide or as narrow as you want. It's totally up to you. Okay, like I said, now it's all about assembly. So kick back, relax, and have fun assembling your card. So I feel like my scene has got it going on here. It's got a little flower action, the little leaves, got my umbrella going on. Super fun, super cute. So now we just have to pop it up on our card base. And there we go. Wish You Were Here, all finished. Super sweet, super cute. Perfect to send to a friend that you're missing. So we'll let that set there so you guys can catch up, finish up, and we'll be right back with card number two. Let's get started on card number two. This one is called Celebrate the Good Stuff, and I think you're going to love it. It is our fun little shaker card. So we're gonna need a few little things for this card. We're going to grab our little ATS set that's in your kit called Share Your Smile. So cute, I love all the sentiments on this one. Adorable. And then we've got your pool with a view die. So we'll need that for the little pool and the little window for the shaker card. And of course your card kit. So your card kit is the cute one with the sequins in it and has these little die cuts all cut out for you and all the good stuff. Let me set these other things aside and dig into this kit. I'll just walk you through one little thing. It's not super complicated, but die cuts, stay there. Okay, your sequins, we'll need those in a minute. You've got your clear sheet, and this will be the window for your shaker card, so don't lose that. It's easy to misplace. This little tin pail sheet is just a really pale gray. We use that for the outline of our pool. And then you have in your kit two pieces of whipped cream cardstock. I just kind of wanted to point this out because they're exactly the same. Obviously, it doesn't matter which one you use. You're going to use one for the top of your card, and you're going to use one to paint your background. So just know that there's two exactly the same. Just set one aside. And then we'll use this one to do our background. I'll save my other little pieces here. I wanna start with the background because I feel like let's get that going. It has to dry for a few minutes, doesn't take long, but we might as well get started on that. We're going to use two liquid colors, Turbo Teal and Cool Pool. So very pretty watery colors. Got a square paintbrush here. Square kind of works good for the image I'm trying to get. And then I've just got some water in my little media mister. You could grab water from anything, really. And I'm going to put Cool Pool on my block and Turbo Teal. And I'm not going to initially mix them together right away. But as I do my kind of painting on this background, they kind of might mix together, which is totally fine. And I'm just going to put strokes of water in here. This is going to be plenty for our pool. In fact, why don't we just for funsies pull out the pool dye and then we'll just kind of compare it and make sure. So I just kind of want to put it on here and I can kind of adjust my pool however I want. And now this, because we haven't really saturated the paper, the tiny bit might bleed through, but you can kind of just, you know, let this dry, set this aside while we do some of our die cutting and stuff. So we've got a piece for the window, but then we're also going to put the cute little rim around the pool. That's the one we're going to cut out of the tin pail. This actually is the exact size of your card front. So wherever you do this first die cut is really going to drive the whole placement of your card. Angle it enough so that you have room on either side to put your foam tape. So I'm going to use this little bit of washi tape just to hold that in place, make sure it doesn't shift or anything. And this is a Spellbinders Platinum 6. Of course, if you have the Fun Stampers Journey Machine, it's exactly the same, except a little bit different color. Now I could bring in my tin pail, and I might as well get this one cut while I'm at it. This time you're going to use the center and the rim to get your little outline of your pool. I think while I have the die cutting machine, I'm also going to quickly cut out some of my leaves, and then my die cutting will basically be done. It doesn't really matter which leaves you cut out of which green, but for my card project, I did the brighter green for the larger leaf. By the way, these colors are Limeade and Kiwi. Kind of perfect names for a pool card, right? Okay, so I have three of the larger leaves and two of the smaller leaves. I think that should be good. So now you want to bring in your clear view sheet. You want to bring in your window piece. This is the member, the one we cut out. You want to bring your little frame in. Now we'll do a little adhering. What I'm going to do is I'm going to adhere the frame to the outside of the pool rim. Looks like mine might be a smidge too wide. And then I'm going to flip it over and adhere my clear view sheet down flat. All right, so now we've got our clear view sheet back there, and I know it's like, ooh, super glaring in the camera, but I think you guys can see that. And then we have our pool rim on the other side, looking good. And now we want to build up the background to have some dimension. So I'm going to go ahead and grab my foam tape. This is a Fun Stampers Journey, foam adhesive that we sell in a roll, but you can, of course, use, you know, foam squares or whatever you have. So this time you want to basically have your foam go all the way around the outside of the pool. And this is what's going to hold in your sequins. So it doesn't have to be pretty, but it just has to be complete. So your little cute little sequins don't fall out. Okay, so I'll set that side aside for a second. And speaking of card base, now I'm going to go ahead and grab our original card base that was in your kit. I just want to fold this guy in half. Okay, so we want our pool background behind here. So remember, we have this fun piece and mine feels pretty dry. You can use a little heat gun or whatever if you want to make sure that it's, you know, completely dry. And you are going to have to trim this card piece down. Now on the back side, it doesn't matter if this covers completely or not, because again, that's going to be mounted on your card front. So keep that in mind. You know, the back, again, doesn't have to be pretty. It just has to be very functional. All right, so I want to place my sequins onto my pool water here, and you might have too many sequins, so just kind of use your best judgment on how many you want in your shaker card. You kind of want to dump them so they're basically in the middle of your pool. And I want to have enough that my water shows, so I might take out a couple of these bigger shells. If you have extra, you can use them for another project. And there we go. Just kind of a gentle pressure. You can kind of pick it up with your hand and make sure that, you know, foam is all sealed up in the back here. Some of my foam is still showing right here, which is fine. I'm going to add a little bit of adhesive here when I put it on my card front, but look how cute. Now the fun part. Shake, 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 shaking. Having all your cute little splash zone sequins in there. So fun. I love my little bent piercer for doing that adhesive, by the way. Okay, so now we have our pool. We'll make sure it's right side up. And then this card front basically goes the exact same size as your card base. So there's not going to be any kind of mat showing. And it's white on white, so it's all good. Just get it lined up as best you can there. And pop it right on top. So fun. Now, again, it's like your blank slate of your pool now. You can have fun decorating it. So bring in your leaves, and then you've got all these other fun little die cuts in your kit. Got some flowers, a couple little kind of heart blossoms here, and then, of course, our sentiment strip. May go ahead and stamp that right now, so then I can just go and assemble the whole card. We are going to use the Celebrate the Good Stuff stamp from the little ATS. There's a lot of cute sentiments on here. You could really put anything. We're just going to stamp it in black licorice. I'm going to have a little bit of a space for a banner cut over here, so just kind of do it in the more or less center of your strip there. So I cut down the middle first, and then my two little flags come out nice and even that way. And then your strip probably is extra long, so I'm just going to kind of place this here-ish until I get my flowers on. Some little white flowers. You can kind of shape these with your fingers a little bit. And you want to grab some foam squares. Because we have the sentiment here, the little bit bigger cluster is going to be at the bottom of your pool here. You can just kind of sit back and relax and glue all your little pieces on. Okay, now I've trimmed my sentiment down, and I just want to add a cute little staple at the end. It's really just for a little accent, no other reason. Let me grab my little bit bigger foam squares for my sentiment. I'm going to pop that up, kind of overlapping the pool, and then add my last few flowers. Okay, we are just about done. We want to grab your little sparkles out of your kit. You've got some blue sparkles. They match perfectly with our water, so you just want to add those to the center of your flower. All right, and there we go. You've got your fun little shaker card, your fun little flowers, your Celebrate the Good Stuff sentiment, and of course it's got your little dimension there as you have your window in the front. Love it, love it. Congratulations on finishing card number 2. We'll go ahead and freeze this there for just a minute, and we will be right back, and we'll start on card number 3. Super great job on finishing your first 2 cards. Now we've got card number 3, and we're going to kind of switch gears and go to another part of our collection. And I'll still share the card and the stamp set we're going to use. This next card is called Enjoy the Ride. It's a super fun, super bright, colorful, have kind of a fun technique with this little background window here I think you'll get a kick out of. Love the colors. Super fun, super bright. Going to be doing a lot of heat embossing on this one, so get your heat gun ready. This is a stamp set, so again, this is sort of the other part of our Happy Place collection. Enjoy the Ride is just an awesome stamp set. 21 stamps, has all these great little embellishments. We're going to be using it actually on the last 2 cards in this kit. So the kit you're going to want to grab out is your bright, colorful one, of course, with your watermelon, beach ball, and all your bright colors. So your little strips, we're actually going to be trimming these a little bit more narrow, so keep that in mind as we kind of start creating here. Twine, we'll set that aside for later. You do have some circles all already pre-die cut for you, and these are just a lot of our basic journey circles. Circle around, I believe we used. I'm actually going to fold my card base just real quick and get that out of the way. All right, so we're going to have a plain white card base. We won't need this right away. But this is going to be the interesting part. You can go ahead and look at the directions on your postcard too, but we're going to basically kind of trim up from the bottom of this front panel. We're going to trim away that little window part that's right in here. So you're going to want to grab your trimmer, and I suppose you cut either way, but go ahead and line it up at 1 inch. So 1 inch from the bottom, I'm basically cutting it at 1 inch. I'm going to keep this part because I still need it from the bottom of my card. So basically that's our little window. Same with these strips right here. We're going to cut them into 1/2 inch. They are 1 inch right now, but just to kind of give you the idea of this technique, thought, well, we could go ahead and trim them. This just gives us a little more variety in our stripes that we're putting on. So trim those basically in 1/2 or to 1/2 inch. Okay, so now we're going to bring in our original card base, our folded card base, and we have all these fun little 1/2 inch stripes. I'm going to trim these approximately in 1/3, so I have lots of choices, and they don't have to be exact because the edges aren't going to show. Now, this will be kind of the fun part. We're going to basically make a pattern across this section of our card. You can use any glue you want. I'm going to start with black, and then I am just going to bring in these 2 pieces that I cut just to make sure that I'm in the right spot, which I can see that I am. As long as you're pretty close to this area of your card front, you will be golden. Okay, make sure that first strip is very straight. Now I'm just going to come on and add glue. And as I go along, continue adding strips to fill the entire card window, I guess we'll call it. I'm going to use a repeating pattern, but of course you can use any pattern that you want. I really like using the craft glue for this technique because you have that extra few seconds just to adjust and move everything into place. You can see that mine's not perfectly straight, but it's all good. It's going to get covered up, and you have lots of strips left over, so you could probably make this card or a similar technique over a few more times. So these are just extras for you to have in your stash. And then when I let this dry, I'm going to go ahead and trim this off. So I'm going to let that dry for a few minutes first. Meantime, let's do some stamping. Okay, so we have our three main circles, and you can go ahead and again refer to your postcard if you want to know which gets stamped where. But I'm going to stamp all three of them in clear pigment ink. I'm going to add my white embossing powder, sprinkle it on top, and heat emboss. And you probably already know how to heat emboss, but just in case, you can take a look at how I do it, and off you go. By the way, this is my Journey heat tool, so you can use this if you have it, or any heat tool. So we will need our card base, and remember we're going to trim this little extra black off of here. It's all dry now. And then of course you need your little panels for the front. We'll do these guys first because they get popped up. We'll add these two to our front of our card base, and again they just line up with the, you know, all the way to the edges. Pop these guys up. Alrighty. And a sentiment strip, which actually I did off camera, is the same exact technique as the other three white emboss, just clear pigment ink, white embossing. And this guy's gonna kind of come right in here somewhere. I try to keep the sentiment fairly centered on this black strip, but I am gonna cut a banner out of the one side. Kind of get my bearings here. So I'll trim it a little bit shorter so I can get my banner kind of coming in this way. Try to give you a little bit extra cardstock so you can make your own fine adjustments there. I'm not going to trim this one until I get it adhered on. And before you do this, grab your black and white twine. This is just a little sample. We of course sell this in big rolls. So you just kind of want to wrap it around your Enjoy the Ride sentiment. I didn't even do a bow, as a matter of fact. I just did a little sweet little knot, kept it simple. And this just kind of ties in the black and white colors from the rest of the card. All right, now finishing the card is really simple. We're just going to pop up a few of our different elements. The actual original circle here just gets adhered flat. And then I popped up the other two circles. Kind of overlap the little carousel. Goes pretty close to the card edge over here. This is kind of fun to even go a little bit lower and let it hang over this little striped portion. So again, when pieces of your card kind of go out over the edge, it really adds a lot of movement to your card. We've got our black dots. And the last one, again, remember the tip I just shared, kind of hangs off the edge. And last but not least, you have some little gems. And you've got a variety of sizes. You can use any size you want. So again, kind of place those around at your own discretion. This card is quite easy, right? So super fun, got a little dimension there. You've got this fun embossing and it really sparkles in real life. It's so pretty, all the fun little gems on there. And Enjoy the Ride, what a perfect sentiment for really just about anything. Birthday, just thinking of you, anniversary, just any of those fun occasions. So we'll let that card sit there as you finish up your embossing and assembling. And we'll be right back to finish up this kit with card number 4. So exciting, 3 cards down, 1 to go. And this last one just might be my favorite card. I sometimes do that, save my favorite for last. But this is a really great card. It's called Life is a Roller Coaster, and maybe it's just all about building the scene. I love doing cards like this, all the fun little elements. So we're layering up a bunch of stamps. So we have this fun die cut in the back that's like a little hillside or whatnot. And I love the sentiment. Life is a roller coaster, certainly is. So this is a card we're going to be working on. We're going to, of course, need our Enjoy the Ride stamp set back. We're going to share a fun technique with a neat product we have called Create a Palette. Share that. And then our last card kit is, of course, this guy has a pre-cut little scalloped rectangle. This is kind of your little, the whipped cream that's cut to size to fit your little beach ball mat, or beach breeze, I should say, is the one you want to create your scene on. So don't stamp on this one right away. You want to set that one aside. You should also have in your kit a larger piece of whipped cream. I don't know if yours is quite as big as this one here, but anyway, it's going to be a large piece. So these pieces you could just set aside. I'm going to go ahead and start with our stamping piece. And so that would be, again, your larger whipped cream. So the product I'm going to share with you today is called Create a Palette, and it's how we got that really fun variety of ink colors on our stamps. I do have two, the one we're going to stamp with today, but I wanted to share one. I'm going to switch them here. That wasn't all the way inked up, just to kind of show you what it looks like. And normally when you get this brand new, this is just raw felt pad. In other words, there's no ink, nothing on it. And then you can add whatever ink you want. You can add our re-inkers from Fun Stampers Journey, or you can add our liquid colors, which is what I have here. So I kind of wanted to share what one looked like that was partially blank. I'll use that in a demo video. But our color palette that we're going to be using today, I'm going to kind of lay it out for you here, and then I'm going to add a little bit more liquid color just so you can kind of see how to do it. But let's get our inks in order here. We've got Catalina Splash at the very end, and these, of course, are on your postcard too. Then we've got Turbo Teal coming in. We have green in the middle, Limeade Splash. Then we go to orange and a Candy Apple Red at the end. So I picked these colors. They're just bright, cheerful, seem to be very appropriate for our fun little amusement park rides. And so to add color to these is really simple. The liquid colors have nice little tips on them. You just gently squeeze and you just add color to that felt pad. Now your colors are going to somewhat run together as you add them onto your pads. So again, you don't want to oversaturate, but you do want to get a nice amount of color. And we're going to bring our whipped cream in. I have a couple stamps already on blocks, but I'm going to grab the roller coaster. I just go ahead and grab my color palette and I kind of decide, okay, do I want it blue at this end, red at this end? You know, it doesn't matter, but you want to keep that in mind when you put it, your stamp pad to your rubber stamp. And then I slightly move mine to the left and right so those colors blend just a little bit. And I want to make sure it's inked up really well, but I don't want it, you know, running all over. Because I could use a little bit more in the middle. Make sure that green's on there nicely. And then you just go to your paper, of course. Pressing firmly, let that ink, which again is water-based, kind of make sure it's soaked into your paper well. And there we go. You can kind of come a little bit closer with the camera. You can see all those fun little variations of ink, right? So my colors down here kind of combined and created a little bit of a purple. Then we've got our teals, greens, oranges, and into our red. So cute, like so easy. It just makes that stamp totally come to life. I love it. Now for my Ferris wheel, I kind of want to go more on the blue and green end. Okay, so more blues and greens there, as you can see. And then when I do my little carousel, I'm going more at the other end. So how fun, right? One ink pad, three stamps. They actually really look different, all three of them. So it's a super fun, super easy way to create your custom colors going on. And now, if you know me, we're gonna do a little detail cutting, something I enjoy. So you just wanna grab your small detail shears and then just go ahead and detail cut around each of these images so we can layer them up, super cute. And there we go. Three fun little images cut out. Now we can bring back in some of our other pieces of the main card kit. Before we start assembling though, I thought it would be fun to add a little bit of color to the background of the panel. So I'm gonna grab one of our Fusion sponges and some Beach Breeze. This just gives a really pretty sky color. And of course it does match our cardstock too, which means your card will coordinate. Now I know that my grass is gonna be covering, you know, part of this, so I kinda want my sky to come out from behind my grassy hill here. So I'm gonna pop up. There's a lot of foam squares on this guy. I'm gonna pop up my grass and then start building my scene from there. Looks like it's gonna be a sunny day at the amusement park today. And this just should go even with the bottom of this panel, so really no white is going to show at the bottom. Then I can go ahead and put it on this piece right here. Might as well have it all ready to go with my mat here. Okay, now you also have two little clouds in your kit. So these are little die cuts from our Sweet Home Accents die. I'm gonna kind of pop those on first because they're the very back layer. Okay, so Roller Coaster is the biggest one and it's gonna go way in the background and fairly high on the panel. This kind of obviously looks like it hangs off the hill, but your Ferris wheel is gonna cover that. So don't worry that it looks a little bit funny right now. All right, so actually, can you guys see what it says on this little roller coaster ticket booth? Yep, it's called the Hurler. I hope not, but sometimes it's the little details that make you smile. Your Ferris wheel is going to go pretty far over this direction and fairly low on the card too. You can go almost all the way to the bottom of the grass. So again, just kind of layering up. I'm going to bring in this piece of white cardstock and grab my sentiment, which like I said, is this time is life as a roller coaster. So one little tip to fussy cutting this one or detail cutting it, I just follow the shape of the words, but instead of cutting it off at the end of the R, I'm gonna leave that open because I'm actually gonna cut a little kind of a banner cut down there. I thought I added just a cute little element to our sentiment. And you will see that the shape of this really nicely kind of fits right in the curve of that roller coaster. So perfect. This guy did not pop up. Of course you could if you wanted, but I just adhered the rectangle flat. And I center it on my card base here. And then yes, this gets popped up again. If you think there's too many dots, you can just adhere it flat too. It'll be perfectly adorable. Okay, and you have one little pack of dots. So I thought kind of fun just to sprinkle them around. And that just finishes this little guy. Like how sweet and colorful and really not difficult at all. It looks complicated because of all the colors, but just by using that creative palette, it turns out so sweet and so adorable. I'll pause that card there just a minute, let you catch up, and then we'll be back to show all four of our cards and have a little roundup. So let's take a look at all four of our finished cards. You guys did a great job. It was so fun. I love virtually crafting with you. Okay, our first card, Wish You Were Here, adorable. And then we've got our other pool themed card, Celebrate the Good Stuff. I guess this was next, Enjoy the Ride, and our Life is a Roller Coaster card. So great, so fun. I hope you enjoyed this Happy Place project kit. And as always, you can check out all of these supplies at spellbinderspaperarts.com. Check out all of our new releases. We always have something new, and you even check that Coming Soon tab. That tells you what's coming down the pike next. Again, enjoyed making this video tutorial for you for the Happy Place Project Kit. I hope you had as much fun as I did. And as always, enjoy bringing paper to life.